translator that takes as an input high level language program and translate it into machine level language. Then the answer would be compiler. It is not interpreter. If I say a line is high level language program, line is translator, then interpreter. That is at least relevant. Seven members, okay, I agree. But assembler, it takes assembly code and it generates machine code, no way related. Please note the point. Assembler will take assembly code and it produces machine code. Preprocessor, not at all related. So these two members, please understand what is the right answer. I'm moving on to next question. The topper D0, G2, D4, congratulations. How quick you are giving answer, how right you are giving answer, depending upon that, it will rank you. That is a hint. So that don't hurry up. Nothing to worry. Very good. 25 members given right answer. See, several files means what? Header files are different. You consider your C program. You write a program with a header file. Without that, not possible. stdio.h, conio.h, stringio.h, something like that. Then you will write a user-defined program. User-defined program will sit in different memory location. Then all together, these are all treated as several files. Then it will combine. It has a single program of relocated machine code ready for relocating. Relocating is done by loader, linker or link editor. Either way you can use, both are right answer. Then others are not right answer. Lexeme not at all related. Why do you choose Lexeme? Preprocessor at least little clash I can think. Loader is also little clash. So be correct with this answer. Understand linker always combines several modules or files into a single program that is ready for relocatable. That's it. You need to remember. Fine, fantastic. Let us move to next question. Get ready. Yeah, the toppers are G5, E1, D7 right now. Very good. 27 right answer. Lexeme. Group of logically related characters in a source program is called Lexeme. Sometime token you may get confused. That is fine. Why? But why you do choose buffer and parser? Buffer is a hardware. Hardware will not do any collection of character. Only your logical program will do. Then parse tree, I haven't even started it. So in that aspect also you would have not chosen. then you are tie between only token and lexeme. But first it deducts the lexeme. So role of the lexical analyzer is to identify the token. So this sentence is related to grouping of the character, relevant character until the delimiter, so that it is called exactly lexeme. This is a justification answer. Right now the toppers are G9, D3, G5. Congratulations. Let's move to the next question. Very good, 28 right answers. Others, see, the name of the question itself mentions semantic consistency. Then naturally semantic analyzer only will suit. That way at least you would have done. Intermediate code generator role is to give three address code, that is different. Lexical analyzer is for scanning your program, tokenizing. Syntax analyzer is for understanding your syntactic correctness. Semantic only will verify the type check. All the consistency check is carried out by semantic analyzer. Consistency check, type check. G9, D7, G2, congratulations. Very good. Mostly you became correct. Code optimization. The role of code generator is to generate the code. Optimization is for reducing the time, reducing the memory space. Already I mentioned while class itself, code optimization. Whenever you say optimization, it's for betterment. For example, marriage optimization. What is the meaning? You need to reduce the expenditure. So here code optimization means to a time reduction, space reduction or memory reduction. Here I would have mentioned memory for better understanding. Here I mentioned the space. That is the only thing. Intermediate code generator, not at all the role. That is for first generating intermediate code. But optimizing means what? Further improvement, reduction. Semantic analyzer over. The previous case is related to semantic analyzer. D7, C8, G2, toppers so far now. Very good. 34 members right. The phase is involved whenever fault or error occurs in the compilation process. Error handler. The word fault may be disturbance for you. The meaning is error occurs. Purposely recoined. The phase which is involved. Invoked means involved. Whenever any error occurs in the user program or in the compilation process, then which routine will work for? Error handler is the phase or routine will work for. Very good. Compiler construction tools. Maths, there is no math at all. While writing only, tools or programming only will be useful. At least I can agree programming. Better that no one has chosen none. Maths never it will be useful. Maths is useful, but I have mentioned very clearly. Construction of a compiler, the compiler writer uses what? Then tools only. Programming tool, I agree, but that also not correct. Compiler construction tools only right. And in spite, I have committed a spelling mistake also, so that is not at all right. So math, those who have preferred, try to understand why I am telling not math. Finally, anything you speak to computer, math you cannot do. You need to convert in terms of logic, program, in terms of tool or software. That way you try to interpret. That's it. Pass. In the beginning itself, I mentioned no, this question already leaked out. I said collection of several phases into a single component is termed as pass, I said. That is one terminology, that's it. That is why I connected with you front end, back end, machine dependent, language dependent, or language independent, machine independent. These are all the terminologies I have brought in the beginning of the session itself. Maybe latecomers would have not noticed. That might be the reason. The activities of, we discussed the six phases of compiler. Among six phases, any cost, if you are trying to combine more than one phase into a single component, then it is termed as pass. That is technical terminology. That's it. Yeah, very good. Producers target code for another machine. For example, Windows machine. Then you want to run on, deploy it on Linux machine. Then it will give the target code suitable to that machine. That kind of compiler is termed as cross compiler. Good. It had gone very low. Please, first phase is what? Lexicon analyzer. Then it would be the interface between the user and the rest of other program. Source program you are writing in the editor. Some editor you will use Turbo C kind of editor. Then that is the source program. Then from the source program to rest of the compiler, which is going to act as an interface. Very first phase, lexical analyzer. That way you should need to interpret. See, parser is somewhere available, syntax analyzer is somewhere available. Parser, there is no phase at all. The name of the phase is syntax analyzer. Within syntax analyzer, parser is the concept. It is not the phase name. Then semantic analyzer, it is far away. Then who will be the interface between rest of all the phases of compiler and your source program is lexical analyzer. Read carefully. Very good. Most of you became right for this. The role of lexical analyzer, even for 2-mark exam question, you need to write this only. Performing expansion of macros, correlating error messages with the source program, striping or skipping. If you don't find this word easy for you, skipping. Skipping out the comments and white spaces. Or removing. You can use better word removing. Removing all the comments and white spaces. These are all the three major role carried out by lexical analyzer. In addition to that, you can write token recognition. I would have kept one more, but the Kahoot doesn't permit. That is a major role of lexical analyzer. Token recognition is a major role other than these three. Performing expansion of macro is also carried out by lexical analyzer. The major purpose is token recognition or identification. See that A is an identifier, that's all. A is identified as identifier, clue itself given. See, what is A? It is a variable. A is equal to 10. What is identifier definition? Identifier is user permitted instances in the program, which are all users are given the privilege to do. One is name of the function, constant name, variables. These three only you can do, especially in C language. It permits you for the user defined header file is also possible. That is advanced level, I'm telling. User also can create one header file. So header file name and file name and what else function name, all the variables, constants, five things. Remember, file name, function name, constant name, variables. These are all the instances permits header file name, permits user choice. Whenever a program is giving the privilege for the user choice, those are all the instances are termed as identifier. So A is the identifier. People tries to declare the variable A is equal to 10. This is Fortran code. 10 to 50 do. It is a looping statement. It is in the Fortran code. Let's move on. Only two more questions. It's a regular expression. Transition diagram itself works on regular expression. A dash is a compact notation that is used to represent the pattern corresponding to a token. Any pattern we can represent first only with a regular expression. After regular expression only it is possible to write a transition diagram. Especially in a computer, it is possible to represent regular expression than even transition diagram. It is easier. Transition diagram, again you need to write a code like a switch case statement or like a flow control statement. You need to write a code, whereas regular expression no need to write a code. There are several components automatically recognizes the regular expression. The answer would be regular expression. Yeah, star means zero or more occurrences. Already we discussed last year also, you would have studied. It is a clean star, clean closure operator. Whenever you see star, wherever you see, that signifies zero or more instances. Why do you choose positive closure? I haven't used plus, no. Plus means positive closure. What is union? Either I can use plus or slash or union symbol itself. Only then it is union. Otherwise, it is not at all union. Comma also. But intersection is what? Nowhere regular expression plays a role with intersection. No chance of choosing intersection at all. This is the question related to your last semester, not even for this semester. Understand, it is available in this semester too. This is 32nd question, true or false? Very good. 41 members became right. Congratulations, toppers. D4, 349, 373. 5G, D1, yeah, 5G. Congratulations. G2, D1, D4. D1, D4. Hey, no, if your name, could you unmute and speak to me for a while?
Yes, ma'am. I'm Praneet, ma'am.
Congratulations, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Other two members?
G2, ma'am. Jayvardhan.
Oh, very good. Congratulations, Jayvardhan. G2,
thank
D4.
You, ma'am.
Vikram, ma'am.
Vikram, very good. Congratulations.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, guys. See you guys. Hope you have enjoyed taking part in the session. I'll be uploading the same video also. Keep watching for further. Those who are
asking.